God has revealed to us today through what we have sang together, said together, shared together. It's so beautiful and it fits in so perfectly well with what we're about to read from God's holy word. His word of truth. His word of truth. There's only one truth, Jesus the Christ. I am the way, the truth, and the life, be his peace. This church has gone through a lot over the past 6 months. We've lost some dear saints temporarily on this side of eternity. Charlie Cobb being one of them. Steve Siegel being another. And many of us here today have lost loved ones. Moms, dads, sisters, brothers, even children, dear friends. Yesterday I had the privilege of officiating the memorial service in remembrance and honor of Steve, and most importantly, to the glory of God. And I thought that today, on the heels of that, and all that we've gone through together, what better message from the Word of God than a message about our spiritual inheritance. Our spiritual inheritance, what God has given us through His Son, Jesus the Christ, through faith by His grace. God, through the Apostle Paul in Ephesians chapter 1, verses 1 to 14. Paul, an apostle of Christ Jesus by the will of God, to the saints who are at Ephesus and who are faithful in Christ Jesus, grace to you and peace from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ. Blessed be the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who has blessed us with every spiritual blessing in the heavenly places in Christ, just as He chose us in Him before the foundation of the world, that we would be holy and blameless before Him. In love, He predestined us to adoption as sons through Jesus Christ to Himself, according to the kind intention of His will, to the praise of the glory of His grace, which He freely bestowed on us in the Beloved. In Him we have redemption through His blood, the forgiveness of our trespasses, according to the riches of His grace, which He lavished on us in all wisdom and insight. He made known to us the mystery of His will, according to His kind intention, which He purposed in Him, with a view to an administration suitable to the fullness of the times, that is, the summing up of all things in Christ, things in the heavens and things on the earth. In Him also we have obtained an inheritance, having been predestined according to His purpose, who works all things after the counsel of His will, to the end that we who were the first to hope in Christ would be to the praise of His glory. In Him you also, after listening to the message of truth, the gospel of your salvation, having also believed, you were sealed in Him with the Holy Spirit of promise, who is given as a pledge of our inheritance, with a view to the redemption of God's own possession, to the praise of His glory.